Up for your model review pleasure is AMT's re-release of Dyno Don Nicholson's Eliminator 2 Mercury Cyclone drag car. This is not going to be the exact same kind of car that we just got from Model King. This is a little bit of different variation. This is more of the dragster type with the flip-up body. So let's take a look at everything that's going to be in the box when you get yours. You can already see that we've got quite different parts. We've got an open hood. We've got a completely different chassis. We've got a completely different interior style tub. And we're getting a lot of cool parts out here, so we'll start taking a look in just a second. Let me get all the white plastic out here. Here's our big 427. Some parts have fallen off the tree, but it's just the other half of the engine, stuff like that. So you'll see the representative parts as you have them on there. This one's got a blower too. We've got nice headers. We've got the collectors for the headers as separate pieces. We got a drag chute, all kinds of stuff that wasn't in the Model King release. You can build a completely different dragster. Got our nice roll cage, braces, narrowed rear end, firewall, the dash. There are no dash decals, but we've got nice instrumentation in there, and you'll be able to bring that out with a little painting. We've got beautiful seat texture. Check out those traction bars. Drilled out, molded clean, and everything. We've got our interior tub, extremely simple. Just bare metal and the pedals, and that's it. We've got our second seat. We've got our exhaust dumps off those collectors. We've got our tires. These are Racemaster tires. They do have raised lettering. We'll see that later when we get some paint on them. And they're made out of hard styrene, and it's very easy to paint those black and make them look like vinyl or rubber tires. We've got that nice hood with the big scoop in it for the blower. We've got wheel backs, and we've got our front tires on there, molded in styrene. This is the back of the tub, and by tub, I mean it's been tubbed for sure. There's no door panel detail. It doesn't need it on this kind of a car. We've got our main chassis, top and bottom, with our frame rails in it, and we've got that nice body. Check it out. Prominent mold lines for the doors means we won't have to carve them any deeper if we don't want to. We've got a lot of nice detail on there. Great looking body. Straight and true, sits nice and level, no issues. Let's get out some smaller parts, and then we will talk about what else is in the box, which is pretty sweet. An updated decal sheet with two versions of the Eliminator 2 coloration on there, so that you can build one of two kits and have decals left over. We got that nice white stripe all done for us. We don't even have to mask the body. We'll just paint it red and be able to put that stripe right on it. And then we have all the other nice Eliminator and Auto Light emblems. Great stuff in the box on this one. We've got our chrome tree with those delicious wheels molded open. We've got our rear bumper, our front grille and headlights, and parts for our blower and suspension. We got our nice 427 valve covers there. And we've got two types of glass. We've got our clear glass and our red tinted glass. So that looks awesome. I'm going to rinse the white plastic off with simple green to take any grease off of it or any oils. And we will be back for a sub-assembly show off. We're going to start off with the body on its roof so I can show you some details on here when we get to them. We've got the 427 assembled as far as I'm going to go with the engine itself. I want to leave the valve covers off and the blower system off because they recommend the engine be painted the same color as the body, so I will oblige, and then I will do the transmission in a metallic when we get to that point. But that's a nice looking 427. It's a big engine, a big wide engine. They've got these exhaust dumps in the kit, and I did assemble them so that I can save them for later. But put them together, they're just two halves, and then stick these in your storage box if you want to build the Eliminator 2. The Eliminator 2 has the headers coming right out of the bottom, just underneath the engine. So we're not going to be using these at all, but they are nice to store for a kit. What we will be using are the full set of headers with the little collectors glued on. That's what's going to be coming out from underneath the car, and that's all we're going to see. So those are glued on instead of the exhaust dumps, so those are all set. This is the belt and pulley system for the blower. I will be painting that black and then using silver to highlight the pulleys just to give it a little detail. The front little bitty shocks, the parachute, and the battery will all be done in a black tone. The hood, of course, will be done in the body color, same color as the engine. The interior tub, this is what actually goes inside the body. It's going to attach to the body. The chassis and the tub underneath there are attached to the frame. This will be painted a lighter color. I want contrasting reds in this. I don't want everything the exact same red color. It's just a personal choice with me. So this will be painted the interior color. And then when we glue the glass into the body, this will be glued in on top of it per the manual's instructions. The roll cage I'm going to do in black just for visual interest inside what I call the cockpit. So that's all set up that way. The wheel backs, get them out of here, it's hard to get a hold of them. The wheel backs are going to be done in a metallic to match the wheels themselves. So those are going to be all set up. Now, normally I could attach the wheel backs to the back of the wheels. I would just sand this down and use model glue to get the plastic to join. But we are using plastic tires. And see how nice they turn out when you glue them together? These are the Racemasters. So these are the drag tires in the back. These are the front skinnies. They go together well. They're just going to require just a little bit of sanding and rounding off on the front tires before I paint them. But if you try to put the wheel backs on these wheels and then push this plastic tire over it, you're either going to destroy the rim or destroy the tire. Even Hercules would end up breaking a lot of stuff trying to do that. So first, what I'm going to do is black out all of this, and then I will be spraying it with my nice metallic to give it a little bit of a different metallic sheen. I think I'm going to cut the wheels free and leave them a bright chrome, but the rear bumper, the front bumper, the valve covers, the fuel pump, the rear shocks, and the wheelie bars back here are all going to get done up with that nice Rust-Oleum bright chrome. That's how I want to do it. I'm also going to be doing the blower housing in that. I'm going to be doing the blower scoop with a metallic tone, and the fuel tank as well. I want to redo them now that I've glued them together so we can get that all set up. The traction bars here, those will be done up the exact same way. I want to do those in a kind of a bare metallic tone. I'm not sure exactly which metallic paint I'll use right now, but that's how I'll be doing it. I'm also going to do the same with the body braces. These actually go on the chassis and hold the body up when it opens up like the funny car. So those will be done up in the same manner. The interior components here, the seat, steering wheel, and dashboard will be done in the same lighter tone red that I'm going to be doing my tub and my frame in. Now, we'll get to that part, the frame and the body. First, just loosely in place is the front suspension. Use the mounting points and then use your glues to attach your tie rod, your front axle, and your front springs. Get those all lined up sufficiently. And then take that whole assembly and put it aside, and we'll metallic paint that on the box art. It looks a nice metallic axle. Now I'm going to be doing the whole assembly in a metallic because I think it'll look nice, and then I will hand paint the springs a darker color when I get to them. Rear axle looks nice. Make sure it lines up evenly with the body on the back there. Make sure that your tires will be end up in the center of your wheel wells, and we'll just use the axle to do that. So now we can remove that. It's just in two halves, so that's not nearly as fiddly and weak as the springs in the front axle is. On the body here, we want it to scissors open, like so. So we've got to make sure that things align before we start painting and detailing, because doing this later, they give you these pegs that I showed earlier. Those glue into the body, and there are marks inside the body, groove lines where those go. What you want to do is get your glue, and you rub your glue on the inside and attach these loosely. While that glue is drying, and you've got a good 15 minutes, while the glue is drying, spread it out and stick your chassis posts in there. Now go in and align your wheel wells and your frame with your wheels in the front and the back, okay? Do that, get those lined up straight across. Use your axle, position it in there, of course, more carefully than I'm doing quickly now. Position it in there where you're going to end up gluing it later, so that you know that when you have it in there, your big fatties are going to fit right up inside that wheel well, because that's the look you're going to want when you get it rocked on. So that's how you align that. Then once that's all nice and dry, then go ahead and gently open the body, and this will come out, and ta-da, We've got our pins in the right places. You've let it sit for at least an hour, and you've got that glued in, and that's it. The radiator mount is in the front here. Now, you could paint this black or anything. I'm going to paint it with the body. I prefer that. And I will quickly hand paint the back of the radiator. You're never going to see the front once the bumper's on, but you will see the back, so don't worry about it at all. So I will just hand paint that radiator real quick with some black, but I want this to be red. It's just a personal choice. I want it to look like that. So the body is all set up. Once you get those pin mounts in there, you can just set that aside. That can be painted body color. The interior tub glues to the frame. We'll be doing the entire frame in the interior tub in that lighter color, so that when we lift that body, we'll have a little bit of a lighter red contrasting inside, and it's going to give us a little more detail. Also, what I'll be doing as usual, you'll see in the paint section, I will be coating the interior tub, the frame, the headers, the axles with black primer first. That will give us a much deeper shadow sensation. The body will be primered gray and then painted, so we maintain that lighter tone. So we're going to get working on everything. The tires are just going to need some black, and that's it. And then they will be fine. And they say in the manual that you can then, with the raised lettering, scrape it off. I'm going to see if that works. If that doesn't work, I will go to some aftermarket details that aren't included in the kit to get my RaceMaster tires white lettered on the outside. So when we come back in a second, I'm going to be over in the painting area. Once things are this far out of paint is when, of course, we start our march to the final. Give you a look at the painted parts. Check out the cool shadows on that. When we miss that strawberry fields over there, we get those beautiful shades underneath in the welding areas on the firewall. That's going to look lovely sitting there with the big, beautiful painted up 427. Got the transmission painted as the manual states. The manual states the engine should be red, so that's what I went with. And that will sit in there. That's going to look lovely. That is a brighter shade of red than the strawberry, darker shade of red than the strawberry fields. It is the same shade of red that we did the body in. And the body's looking good, just needs a clear coat now that it's out of paint. And then we'll do the decals, and then we will do the future floor polish, and that'll be all set to go. On that interior, that bucket looks wonderful with the shadows in it from the black, same as our dashboard. Now all I have to do is go in and paint each individual gauge face black with a small marker or a paintbrush, and then around the edge there, we'll let it focus around the edge. We will do our Molotow pen or any silver pen, and then we will take a silver pencil and rub on those high marks inside the gauges, and that will bring us our gauge readings. Then all we have to do is do a little bit of silver painting inside that steering wheel, and that is done as well. The headers look awesome. Check that out. Check out the detail on that when you do a black with a metallic overcoat. They look fantastic, and they're going to look wonderful glued up to that 427. The tires look great. Now, they do have those white letters that will be underneath there. They say just to rub lightly and sand that off, so I'm going to give that a shot. If that doesn't work well for me, if I don't have the steady enough hand to rub that off, that exposed tread there, then I will just use some aftermarket decals. But you can make that choice when you buy your kit if you want to do it on the front. There aren't any raised white letters that I can see. They've got a little bit of detail here on the sides, but I'm not really going to worry about that on the Dragster. We're going to leave those black, and those look great just as they are. Once again, we got that 427 and transmission done. We can start gluing valve covers on. I masked off the differential off camera, left the springs black, and did the differential in a raw metal. I figure that's something that's getting taken off the car and worked on all the time. The wheel backs are done up with the bright chrome paint. Now, I just misted it on these parts, so we had a little bit of an off chrome look and not super, super shiny chrome. On these ones here, it would be very hard to mask the leaf springs when we did anything, so I'm just going to go in and hand paint those black. But our front axle is all painted up and ready to be mounted with that tie rod on there and the springs. The belts, pulleys, and battery and parachute are ready for details. The body props underneath, because it's a funny car, those are painted up in the bright chrome. I changed my mind. Instead of doing this underbelly tub in a body color, I thought it would really stand out and look cool if they just formed it out of sheet metal and stuck it in there. I thought that would look really cool, and why would they waste time painting it and everything? So I like the look of that. That's mine. I use that Krylon hammered steel, and that came out looking really good, like rough worked over sheet metal, just to protect the inside. The roll cage is all ready to go. That's painted black. That just has to be glued in place before we put the body on. To see the difference between the chrome in the kit, which is beautiful on the wheels, and what I wanted to leave, and on the grill, which has to be blacked out with black paint in the front here, and then rubbed a little clean. The difference between the two is nice and striking, though. This is the chrome paint on all these parts, and I just misted it over the black. I didn't give it a heavy coat. If I wanted it to look like the chrome there, I'd give it a very heavy coat, and it would come out much deeper. But I did a mist coat so that it would look like the raw-ish type metal or fiberglass painted that they used on the Dragsters, the lighter weight parts. I don't know if this one used them, but that's what it looks like on the box. They definitely don't look like chrome parts. They look like silver painted fiberglass or metallicized plastic or fiberglass or lightweight aluminum bumpers or something. So that's what I wanted to do on those, and the same effect on those valve covers. So, and the front shocks, those all look nice like that. And the wheelie bars, I wanted to look metal too. And then I will just paint a little bit of black around the wheel back there that rubs on the ground. The rest will be all the metal springs. So those are cool. We got our track bars here, done with the same chrome, just lightly misted, so we didn't get a perfect chrome finish. We just got a metallic finish, and those look great. And then I went a little bit heavier on the chrome finish on the blower scoop. That's going to look great. The blower body looks awesome with that black underneath it. It looks so cool. And since I had to glue everything together, it comes out better when we do it like that than if we would have just glued the chrome parts. It might have looked a little wonky. And our moon tank, our fuel cell. Now, they don't have a recommended area. It's an optional area. So after I get everything together, if I find a place, I will put it in. And if not, I'll leave it out, save it for something else. But I've got it painted and decorated. So we're getting close. This one isn't going to take long. Most of the detail will be fine painting on the engine and that dashboard, and then we'll just start gluing parts together. So I will be back in a little bit. I had to force myself to hit the brakes and throw the parachute out because this kit goes together so quick and I'm not having any issues. So I'm just working away, and all of a sudden I realized, stop, film it. Everyone wants to see what's going on. So what do we have done so far? Are there any fit issues? None whatsoever. Even the glass fits in the body. We'll see that in just a second. I've got the 427 all done. Beautifully detailed engine. Get the hand behind there so the camera can focus on it. That's the color scheme and the way I decided to do mine. And I absolutely love it. She is a beauty. Got the transmission done there. The headers will go on after it's mounted in the chassis. But yeah, that's how she's going to look when you build yours up with the magneto, the water, the fuel pump on the side is what they say, your belt drive system, and your nice blower with those repainted chrome parts. I think that looks absolutely lovely. Can't wait to get it in the chassis. Speaking of the chassis, first we'll go underneath. Now you'll see I cut out that transmission loop there. Because I installed the front suspension, I shouldn't have done it. I shouldn't have glued it in, because then I have to tilt the engine down so far, and that's my mistake. But since I glued it in, I didn't want to break it free because it looks so nice there with the springs painted black, just like the rear springs. What I had to do was cut the transmission loop out so I could dip that engine in low, get the transmission to come down, and then tilt it all in. So that's sitting off to the side. I cut it off with my nippers, and that will be glued back in place. We've got the traction bars, we've got the rear differential in, we've got the springs in, the drive shaft through the loop, and we're all ready to go underneath. That looks lovely. We've got the interior done. Before I forget, the wheelie bars will go on the back like so. And those I'll put on just before I put the decals on, because while I'm snapping the body on, I don't want to break those wheelie bars off the back. So, inside of the chassis, we've got our interior done, and it works out real simple, real well. What I do is I use a small paintbrush to paint black inside the gauges and the decor on the dash. Then I go in and I use a silver pencil. And when I say silver pencil, people, I mean silver pencil. And the brand doesn't matter, silver pencil. Lightly rub the indications on the gauges that are molded in. The silver will come off if you lightly rub just on the high points. Then using a silver gel pen, when I say silver gel pen, that's what I mean. This is a metallic one that I got at Hobby Lobby. You can just pick them up, and then I do the gauge rings. Very easy to draw with a nice ballpoint tip like that. Super easy, takes a little bit longer to dry than a normal pen ink, so just put it on the side, leave it alone. Detail the ignition, another button they had on the dash, around the decoration there on the dash, and the gauges. Also did the steering wheel like so, did the battery with the same kind of gel pens and other colors. Even used them to do those nice belts molded into the seat. And those look fantastic. So our interior is done, being a dragger, nice and simple. The headers are all set, ready to go to be glued on from the underneath once the 427 is in the chassis. You can see where there's two little detents on the bottom of each cylinder head. That's where those will go from underneath, and they will just dump out underneath the car. Got my rear bumper. All I had to do with that is just color in the taillights. Even though it's a dragster, they're probably not operational. Their parachute will be one of the last things I glue on. Once I put the rear bumper on, the reason I didn't put the rear bumper on the body was, of course, as we know, I have to stretch that body to fit over those two mounts. And if I put the rear bumper on, it mounts to these three things here. I still didn't want to chance it when I opened it up of flexing the trunk and popping that bumper off. So I'm going to leave that on until after I get the body on the chassis. Since the hood fell off, we'll talk about it. I did the hood pins on the hood. Left it primer underneath. Why would they paint the bottom of a race car? It only adds 4 ounces of weight. So we've got the grill done and mildly blacked out. Got the front bumper on, looking like it's lightweight substitution. So the body looks spectacular. We're not going to do any trim or moldings. Why would they do them on a dragster? They wouldn't on a funny car body, especially. So we've got the interior. I love that I did that gray now. That really fits the part, especially when you look through the back window. You can see it like so. We did the trim with a silver Sharpie marker that I've shown you a million times. Just a silver Sharpie marker for all the trim work. And it comes out lovely around the glass. No windshield wiper blades. And because we primered in gray with the red, we already have our black accents in that vent. So the body is ready to go. We're not going to be doing any of the emblems. They would have peeled all that stuff off anyways. Every little ounce of weight. The wheelie bars are done in black casters and then just left it with that metallic color as the big spring. Those are ready to go. The tires came out exactly the way they suggested I should do it. I just took my X-Acto knife and lightly scraped across the black paint. And sure enough, just like they said, those white letters came out. So we're all ready to mount those with those silver inserts. And those are ready to go just as they are. Nice, shiny chrome wheels. It's a dragster. They don't have a chance to get dirty. We've got our front tires there. So those will just press on. All I have to do is snap the body on. I have to get the engine in the frame. Snap the body on the chassis, which will take a couple seconds. Glue my rear bumper on. Glue my parachute on. And then I will use yellow colored gel pens to do the cross sections of the rope that holds the parachute together. And when you yank, it lets them go and opens them up. So that's going to just take a few seconds. Then I've got to put the decals on. So when I come back, of course, we'll be on the turntable looking at a completed Eliminator 2. See you in a minute. The AMT Dyno Don 125th scale Eliminator 2, his Mercury Cyclone. We're all done. This is the dragster with the flip top body. So let's display it as it's made with that cool flip top body. Now I just put the future floor polish on. That's going to dry to a beautiful shine and we're still going to show it off. That's how versatile future floor polish is. I can display it while it's drying and it's not going to hurt anything. It's the miracle clear coat. Literally, it's the poor man's miracle clear coat. For those of us looking to save a buck, you just rub it on with a brush and you're all done and you get super glossy finishes. I love that 427. This is a kind of kit, if you don't have a lot of experience with glue kits and you want to give it a try, go ahead. Yeah, it's an older kit, it's been around a while, but it's really easy to put together. The parts count is low, but you end up with an awesome, awesome kit. And like I showed, those tires that you have on there will easily just scrape off with your X-Acto knife. And you can have white letter tires on there without having to use decals or have pad printed tires or anything. There's no alignment issues. You don't have to worry about freaking out and not getting the body on right. It goes on right every time. You can display it up like this. We'll have pictures in the final of it actually with the body all the way down so you can see how it goes together. But it is cool looking at it the way they would have had it parked in the pits and they can still get in it, start it, work on the engine, check it all out and get stuff done. It is a beautiful kit, goes together super easy. A lot of people think the older kits are hard to put together and I'm telling you that a lot of them are not. They just fall together and you're gonna be able to build a beautiful kit. I didn't have to do any adjustments, nothing. I wanna thank Round 2 as always. They sent this kit for review and I'm very glad they did because she is a winner. She goes together real sweet. And you can build this one of two ways with the decals in it. Or you can use this as a base to build a custom dragster of your own. As always, I like to say on these reviews, if you build a kit and you make mistakes, if you don't get this stripe on absolutely perfectly, if you have a little bubble in the paint, it doesn't matter. Go out and buy kits and build them and have fun because this is a hobby and that's what about. So, this is the workshop saying thanks for watching, thanks for your likes, thanks for your cool comments. We will see you at the next review.